There's a lot of interesting characters in Attack on Titan, but Erwin Smith is, without a doubt, one of my favorites, not only because of his badass character, but also his complexity. Today, we're going to look at his top five leadership moments as the commander of the Survey Corps, and for each of these moments, I'll explain how they display a valuable leadership quality. Spoiler alert, this video contains scenes up to season 4 / end of season 3, so if you haven't kept up with the anime, please don't watch this as you will miss out on the emotional roller coaster that Attack on Titan is. Now, let's get started. Number 5, Long Distance Scouting Formation, Highlighting Competency. First of all, let's define what a leader is. A leader is the person who commands a group. When a group needs a leader, it is because they all have a common goal to reach, and a leader helps everyone focus on that. So the most basic thing you need to have as a leader is the ability to influence the group to follow you, and not just by way of authority, like this guy. The best way to influence a group is by earning their respect. To do so, you need to know what you're doing and be good at it. No group of people will follow the commands of someone that clearly doesn't know what they're talking about, unless they're being forced to. As the commander of the Survey Corps, one of the main skills needed is strategic thinking. So they're the ones going outside the walls and risking their lives, so you gotta make sure to be smart about it to not die. In episode 17, Erwin comes up with a very clever scouting formation to lead the group outside the walls.
じゃあな、アルビン。巨人と出くわしても正面積みんなよ。うん。ジャモネ。前方半円上に長距離だが確実に前後左右が見える距離で等間隔に兵を展開。可能な限り索敵
This formation gave them a full view of their surroundings and allowed Erwin to adjust based on the different message of each colored smoke signal. And if you're to ask me, even to this day, I still can't think of a better way they could have done this with the tools and knowledge they had at the moment. If any of you can think of something better, I'd be very curious to know, so feel free to let everyone know in the comments. Number 4, Battling the Beast Titan. Emotional intelligence. The ability to understand and manage emotions can easily increase your chances of success. It is natural to have emotions, but too little or too much of it can hinder your success. The keywords are understand and manage. Let's take fear as an example. Fear of death, more specifically. We're going to compare how it affected the Beast Titan and Erwin Smith during the mission to retake Wall Maria.
そんなもん撃って何になるってんだよ。そんなに叫んで何の意味があるってんだよ。ああ、かわいそうに。 なんだ、俺の巨人が倒れて。え、一人の兵士に気をつけろって。はい、リヴァイ兵長は危険です。こいつがリヴァイか。
何も見えない。目をやられたのか。さっきは随分と楽しそうだったな。こうしつこ。ダメだ、間に合わない。もっと楽しんでくれよ。
as the Beast Titan, he felt invincible. There was no fear in him whatsoever and was even having fun with his rock throws. That's where the absence of fear resulted in him letting his guard down. Because of that, Levi had the opportunity to hit him and almost kill him. Without a question, if he was more afraid of the survey course and feared for his life, he most likely would have been more alert and been able to avoid that situation. Now, let's jump back to how Erwin handled the situation.
Erwin, 鎧が登ってくる。
奴に近寄るな。
了解。
あの四足歩行型、先ほど一斉に巨人化したものではないな。あれが敵の石膏か。我々の接近にいち早く気づき、ライナーらに伝えた。ウトガルド城の襲撃の時と同じく、奴がまず狙うのは馬。
団長、鎧がすぐそこまで。
ああ、分かっている。危惧すべき課題はライナーとベルトルトになすすべなく馬を殺されることか。
やっと何かを喋る気になったか。先に朝食を済ませるべきだった。
ディルクハン、並びにマレーネハンは内門のクラースハンと共に馬を死せよ。リヴァイハン、並びにハンジハンは鎧の巨人を仕留めろ。待て、リヴァイ、アルミン。リヴァイハンと言ったが、お前だけはこっちだ。獣の巨人はお前にしか託せない。
Even on the brink of death, Erwin was able to analyze the enemies thoroughly, from noticing the quadruple titan with the saddle to the enemy's intent to block the exit for the horses, and still devise a plan in a short amount of time. Not only did he stay calm, but also alert, as the fear of failing and dying was definitely keeping him on his toes. Another sign of high emotional intelligence is that Erwin also knows when to let his emotions take over.
フレーゲル、
ウォルマリアを取り返してくれ。
人類の未来を任せたぞ。
領土を取り戻してくれ。
調査兵団がこれだけ歓迎されるのはいつ以来だ。
さてな、そんな時があったのか。
私が知る限りでは初めてだ。
This was one of the few displays of joy by Erwin in front of his comrades. Even Levi was surprised to see it. His scream was a display of joy, but also a factor in motivating the people in the group. Knowing that your leader is fully on board with the mission will surely contribute to the confidence of the entire group. Once again, Erwin shows his ability to manage his emotions. He knows to act on his emotions when they contribute to the mission, but to suppress them when they don't. Number 3. Titan Serum Delegation. Most people think that delegating is the easiest thing to do, and they couldn't be more wrong. Delegating is not about giving all your tasks to your subordinates and having them do the work for you. It's about knowing the strengths and weaknesses of your team members, choosing the right person to do the task, and knowing when it should actually be delegated or handled yourself. All those decisions depend on the nature of the task, the leader's personal knowledge, and the team in place. After obtaining the serum from Kenny, the heads of military set up a meeting to discuss how they should use it. Note that all of the members in the following scene are leaders in their own right, so pay attention to how each of them make use of their leadership skills to make their decision.
遅れてすまんな。それで、瓶の中身は解明できそうなのか？
それがどうも。我々の技術ではこれ以上探ることはできないようです。エレンとヒストリアから聞いたように、人間の骨髄液由来の成分ではあるようなのですが、この液体は空気に触れるとたちまち気化してしまい、分析は困難です。やはり我々の技術とは比較にならないほど高度な代物です。レイスケが作ったのだとしたら、一体どうやって。
ならば下手に扱うよりも当初の目的に使用するほかなかろう。
すると誰に委ねる？エルヴィン、君か？
いえ、私は兵士としては手負いのみです。この箱は最も生存確率の高い優れた兵士に委ねるべきかと。リヴァイ、引き受けてくれるか？
任務なら命令すればいい。なぜそんなことを聞く？
これを使用する際はどんな状況かがわからない。つまり現場の判断も含めて君に託すことになりそうだ。状況によっては誰に使用するべきか君が決めることになる。任せてもいいか？
As you could see, the conversation opened up with the group having two options. Either they keep trying to analyze the serum and risk losing it, or they decide to use it later when needed. Pixies does a good job of rejecting the first option and bringing back the conversation to their core mission, which is to retake Wall Maria to improve humanity's chance of survival. They only have this one serum, so losing it would be a complete failure and is not worth the risk. His decision goes back to our definition of what a leader is. A leader leads the group to achieve a common goal. You always want to go back to that common goal in any decision-making process so you don't get sidetracked. Premier Zachary, who doesn't have as much first-hand battle knowledge at this point, suggests to delegate it to Erwin, since he has been in combat the most and is the one leading the mission to retake Wall Maria. He makes that decision based on his knowledge of Erwin's strengths. Erwin has proven his competency multiple times at this point, even more so after his team retrieved the serum. He then argues that it should go to someone with a higher survival rate and delegates it to Levi. That is both a rational and humble judgment from Erwin, as he admits that he's not the best option here. He's also aware of the responsibility and pressure that this person will have, and makes sure to communicate the implications of being the owner of this serum and the kind of decision he'll have to make. So as you can see, even among leaders and a chain of commands, the leadership qualities are all the same. Number two, the last mission and the ability to inspire. When we talked about competency, we talked about what the core of a leader was, to first be able to influence the group to follow you. I mentioned how you can influence the group by earning their respect after showing competency, but you can also influence them by building a desire in them to act in service of that common goal. Motivation is different for everyone, as people get motivated by different things based on their values and their personal goals. However, good leaders such as Erwin know how to inspire and when to inspire. As a result, he's able to have them follow his lead and do what he thinks needs to be done during crucial moments.
これより最終作戦を告げる。総員整列。総員による騎馬突撃を目標獣の巨人に仕掛ける。当然目標にとっては格好の的だ。我々は目標の投石のタイミングを見て一斉に深淵弾を放ち、投石の命中率を少しでも下げる。我々がおとりになる間にリヴァイ兵士長が獣の巨人を討ち取る。以上が作戦だ。ここに突っ立っていても、じきに飛んでくる岩を浴びるだけだ。すぐさま準備に取り掛かれ。
俺たちは今から死ぬんですか？
そうだ。
どうせ死ぬなら最後に戦って死ねということですか？
そうだ。
いや、どうせ死ぬならどうやって死のうと、命令に背いて死のうと、意味なんかないですよね。
全くその通りだ。全くもって無意味だ。どんなに夢や希望を持っていても、幸福な人生を送ることができたとしても、岩で体を砕かれても同じだ。人はいずれ死ぬ。ならば人生には意味がないのか？そもそも生まれてきたことに意味はなかったのか？死んだ仲間もそうなのか？あの兵士たちも無意味だったのか？
いや違う！あの兵士たちに意味を与えるのは我々だ！あの勇敢な死者を、哀れな死者を思うことができるのは聖者である我々だ！ 我々はここで死に、次の聖者に意味を託す。それこそ唯一この残酷な世界に抗う術なのだ。兵士を怒れ、兵士を叫べ、兵士を戦え。
Note that Erwin was completely honest with their situation and what he wanted to do. He told them straight up that no matter what they decide, they will most likely die either way. This was super important to manage their expectations by shutting down any hope they might have had of surviving. He was then able to set up his next point, which is the inspirational part. He gave them a purpose to die. By telling them that the living will remember them for their contributions,Erwin was able to strike an emotional chord in them and influence them to follow his plan. And lastly, number one is selflessness, putting the team's goal before yourself. When someone leads by example and shows their team how much they care about the mission, they're not only acting as a mentor, but also building trust, motivation, and respect all at the same time. Add all those things together, and it becomes much easier to ask your team to be selfless since you're already doing it so they can trust that you're sincere.The next scene is my favorite scene of all time from Attack on Titan. It pretty much sums up perfectly why I love Erwin's character.
What the hell is this? The
hell? No, this is it! Showing! Totsukaki! What? Humanity's fate is now decided at this moment! Eren without humanity can live on this earth for the future!永遠に訪れない。エレンを奪い返し、即帰還するぞ。心臓を捧げよう。
逃げた。
調査兵団め、奴ら完全にどうかしてるぜ。
おい。
ん？
踏ん張れよ、ベルトルト。あと少し、あと少しなんだ。
やったぞ、手を離した。
今なら。
おい、ミカサ、周りの巨人が見えねえのか。
クスか、誰かあそこまで行けんのかよ。
この巨人の中をかいくぐって
進む。すぐそこだ。進め。
Again, even in the face of death, Erwin stayed focused on the mission to save Eren. He proved to his group once again that the mission was more important than anything, even his own life. Notice how they all stopped when they saw him get bit.The timing was super critical here because if he didn't tell them to keep going, they probably would have tried to save him or would have been stunned for too long and failed to save Eren. This moment is my favorite because it just shows everything that makes him a great leader, from selflessness to emotional intelligence and the ability to inspire when most needed. All the leadership qualities that we've discussed are displayed in this amazing scene, and it gives me chills every single time I watch it.So those were my top 5 moments of Erwin. I'm sure there's a lot more that are just as great, so feel free to let everyone know in the comments below what your favorite moments of Erwin are. And that's it for me. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you on the next one.